My contempt for the viewers of your documentary over the last 11 years knows no bounds. They've been like children, mocking it, or on the other hand, credulously accepting it with no attempt to evaluate the material on its own merits, or to discover any new material to support or debunk it. This is not a joke. This is not a hoax. Certainly I'm staking my reputation on it. If an anonymous individual in a rubber mask could be said to be staking his reputation on anything, I challenge these ufologists to debunk me, discover my identity. If they really believe that the alien interview footage is a hoax, prove it. Show where it was faked. If they believe that the alien in that footage is a puppet, prove it. Find the puppet maker. If they believe that I am a hoaxer, prove it.
Well, just when you thought it couldn't get any better, I've come up with a bunch of new clues that are just as important as the evidence I presented to you in my last two documentaries. I hope you're ready, because this is going to shock the hell out of people, especially the non-believers. If the skeptics still doubt the authenticity of the alien interview video after watching this, then the joke is on them. All I can say to the disbelievers is, stick this analysis in your pipe and smoke it. Okay, here we go now. Get a load of this.
if you see the drawings we have of the Kalahari alien and the descriptions we have, it seems to be the same being. And the Kalahari incident puts the alien interview footage into a context.
That video, more so than the alien autopsy, more so than anything else, has not only stood the test of time, but nobody has come out to debunk it. Nobody has come out and said, oh, ha ha, it's a trick, I did it. We asked special effects people in Hollywood how much money would it take to fake something like this, and they were saying anywhere between, you know, $250,000 and $350,000, and we were thinking, really, and who has that kind of money to just put up some kind of fake like this? And the more that we learned, and I think it was Rick Baker. But he is the one that said, I can do better, and I have done better. And so my challenge to him was, okay, how much? What would it cost for you to do this? And he was the one that said, well, $250,000 to $350,000. And I'm like, really? Okay, so you know, you got somebody that's, you know, so we come up with that kind of money. You're telling me that you could do this, and you're saying that somebody spent that kind of money to fake something like this, and yet take no credit for it whatsoever, release it to the public the way it is, And the way it came about also is that Victor tried to sell it to Fox after the alien autopsy, which he thought was bogus. He contacted Fox, and Fox said, no thanks, we're already in enough trouble. This was Bob Keviat, by the way.